Hello student, in this class so we'll discuss the question based on absolute maximum and absolute minimum of the given function in the given close interval. So what is the given close interval? 0 comma pi is the given close interval. The function f of x equal to sin x plus cos x. Then let us differentiate first f of x equal to sin x plus cos x, where x belongs to the closed interval 0 comma pi. Then we differentiate with respect to x, we can get f base of x cos x minus sin x. If f base of x equal to 0, then cos x minus sin x equal to 0, and this implies tan x equal to 1, and this implies x equal to n pi plus pi by 4, where n belongs to integers. Then x equal to n equal to 0, pi by 4, n equal to 1, more than pi by 4, there is only one value in the closed interval 0 comma pi. So dear student, how to estimate absolute maximum and absolute minimum? We have to find the value of the function at the extreme values of the interval. We need to find f of 0 and f of pi. Other than f of 0 and f of pi, at x equal to pi by 4, f of pi by 4, this is root of f base of x equal to 0 and the extreme values at all the points, extreme values and root of f base of x equal to 0. So for these values of x, find f of x. Of all values, which is largest, that is considered as absolute maximum, least one absolute minimum. So absolute maximum or absolute minimum, including extreme values other than local maxima and local minima. So we have to include local maxima and local minima, including the extreme values f of 0 and f of pi. So we have got only one value, first extreme value, f of 0 equal to sin 0 plus cos 0 equal to 1, and f of pi equal to sin pi plus cos pi, sin pi 0 cos pi minus 1, and f of pi by 4 sin pi by 4 plus cos pi by 4 is 1 by root of 2 plus 1 by root of 2, that is root of 2. So f of 0 is 1, f of pi is minus 1, f of pi by 4 is root of 2. From these three values, absolute maximum of f of x, which is largest value, root of 2 only, root of 2, when x equal to pi by 4, and absolute minimum of f of x, minus 1 is the least value when x equal to pi. That's all. So this is the procedure to find absolute maximum as well as absolute minimum. Just whatever function given, differentiate, just solve the first derivative, find the roots of f base of x equal to 0, take roots of f base of x is 0 along with extreme values of the closed interval, find the corresponding values of the function. Of all the values, which is largest or greatest one, that is absolute maximum, the least of all the values, absolute minimum. So here absolute maximum of f of x root of 2 when x equal to pi by 4, absolute minimum of f of x is minus 1 when x equal to pi. So my dear student, keep watching this, we will discuss one more question. The next question, find absolute maximum as well as minimum. For a function f of x equal to 4x minus x square by 2 for all x belongs to the closed interval minus 2 comma 9 by 2. So similar procedures we are going to follow. F of x is 4x minus x square by 2, where x belongs to the closed interval minus 2 to 9 by 2. These two are extreme values, and this implies x derivative of x 4 minus x. And if f dash of x equal to 0, then 4 minus x equal to 0, this implies x equal to 4. Okay, and the 4 is one of the mean values of the interval minus 2 comma 9 by 2. So we have to estimate f of minus 2 and f of 9 by 2 and f of 4. F of minus 2, 4 into minus 2, minus 2 square by 2, so 4 into minus 2, minus 8, and 2 square by 2, 2, minus 2 equal to minus 10. F of 9 by 2, 4 into 9 by 2, this 2 times, minus 9 by 2 the whole square, 81 by 4 into 2, 8. So 9 by 2 the whole square means 9 by 2 whole square, 81 by 4 into 2, 8. So 2 into 9, 18. 18 into 8 minus 81 by 8. So 80, 64, 144, 144, 81, 4, 1, 3, then 14, 8. 6, so 63 by 8, and other one f of 4, 4 times 4 minus 4 square, 16 by 2, 16 minus 8 equal to 8. Okay, this is less than 8, this is largest value, this is the least value. Now we can conclude absolute maximum of f of x is equal to 8 when x equal to 4. Absolute minimum of f of x is equal to minus 10 when x equal to minus 2. Okay, let's go through it. We'll discuss one more question. The next question, find absolute maximum and minimum for the function f of x is equal to x minus 1 whole square plus 3 for all x belongs to the closed interval minus 3 comma 1. So f of x and x minus 1 whole square plus 3, and where x belongs to the closed interval minus 3 comma 1, and this implies its derivative of base of x equal to 2 times x minus 1. If the base of x is 0, then 2 times x minus 1 equal to 0, this implies x equal to 1. So let us find the extreme value f of minus 3 and f of 1. There is no value between minus 3 and 1. So 1 is one of the critical points. That is, f dash of x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. F of minus 3 and 3 minus 1 the whole square plus 3 and 4 plus 3 is 7. 8. Minus 3. So minus 3 minus 1, 4, 4 square 16, 16 plus 3, 19. Okay, then 1 minus 1 whole square plus 3 equal to 3. From these two values, 19 is the maximum value, 3 is the least minimum value. Therefore, absolute maximum of f of x is 19 when x equal to minus 3 and absolute minimum of f of x is 3 when x equal to 1. Okay, we'll discuss one more question. So next question, find maximum and minimum value of f of x, that is on fourth degree polynomial 3x power 4 minus 8x cube plus 12x square minus 48x plus 25 in the closed interval 0, 3. Okay, so f of x is 3x power 4 minus 8x cube plus 12x square minus 48x plus 25. Then this implies it's a derivative f dash of x equal to 12x cube minus 24x square plus 24x minus 48. And taking 12 is common factor, x cube minus 2x square and plus 2x minus 4. Okay, then 12 into between x cube and 2x square, we can take x square into x minus 2 plus 2 into x minus 2. So x minus 2 common factor means 12 into x minus 2 into x square plus 2. So the x square plus 2 factor is always positive, it cannot be 0. So f dash of x, so if f dash of x equal to 0, then straight away 12 into x minus 2 into x square plus 2 equal to 0. This gives the result x equal to 2, is belongs to the interval 0, 3. So we have to find the values of 2, 0 and 3, extreme values, and including the root of f dash of x equal to 0. So f of 0 constant of straight away 25, and f of 3 and 3 power 4 81, 3 times 81 minus 8 times 27 plus 12 times 9 minus 48 times 3 plus 25. We have to simplify. So 3 times 1 3 24 243 minus 56, then 5 8 into 2 16 plus 5 21 216 and plus and 90 and 18, so 108 minus 3 into 8 24, 3 into 4 12, 14 144 plus 25, adding positive value 5 plus 8 and 13 plus 3 16, 3 plus 0, 3 plus 4, 7 and 1 plus 2, 3, 376 minus 4 and 6, 10, 1, 4 and 1, 5, 6, 1 and 2, 3. So 376 minus 360 is 16, f of 3, and f of 2. F of 2, 3 into 2 power 4 minus 8 into 2 cube plus 12 into 2 square minus 48 into 2 plus 25. So 2 power 4, 16, 3 times 16, 48, and 2 power 3, 8, 8 times 8, 64, and 2 power 2, 4, 4 times 12, 48, and 48 minus and 80 96 plus 25, so 48 plus 48 and 96, all the three cancel, so 64 and 25 and 14 5 9 5 2 39 minus 39. Listen, we have got three values and f of 0 is 25, f of 3 is 16, f of 2 is 39, which is largest value, f of 0. Therefore, absolute maximum is equal to 25 when x is equal to 0, and absolute minimum is 39, minus 39. Absolute minimum is equal to minus 39 when x is equal to 2. So we have got absolute maximum, absolute minimum. Dear student, the word absolute is missing because of the closed interval. It is understood this is singular, not plural form. So see, because of singular form, it should be absolute maximum as well as absolute minimum because of closed interval. So this is a key point. Make note of it and go through it. So my dear student, I am Murugaiyan. My humble request to support my effort, like my videos and share my video link Murugaiyan Subramanian to all 12th standard students of our country, especially your friends of your school and other schools, in all possible ways. So thank you student for watching my videos.